Hi, this is Rich, and we're going to talk about the Overself, the Higher Self, the Oversoul, pick a label, and put on a blindfold, spin around three times, and take that label on a pin and walk it over to that donkey on the frickin' wall and stick it, okay? Now we got a label for this bitch. I'm a little stressed today. I'm talking about this thing, this consciousness that we are that's greater than the consciousness that we are here. And we'd like to call it Oversoul, Oversoul, you know, or Higher Self, something. Or the essence, the true essence that we are, the consciousness of all that is. Oh, my God. What do we call this thing? I don't know. Anyway, okay. Got that little stressful thing out of my system. Have you ever had one of those mornings where it's like, Jesus Christ, nothing's going right? It's just a little offish. You know, you're trying real hard. And what if your Oversoul's up there going, oops. You know, it's like our Oversoul creates us, right? And if your Oversoul creates you, my wife's off here over on the side here, listening patiently, interestedly too sometimes, interestedly. Okay, so if we have this Oversoul or Overself going, is that us? You know, there's a lot of interest in being at one with the higher self, you know, bringing the higher self or the higher consciousness into the here and the now and all of it. How does that fucking work? Yeah. Is it literally like there's another spiritual being that is in and of itself a brighter, lighter being, but it's you, but it's a different person than you, because you're you here, but it's while you're here playing around in Earth, in the Earth plane, in the Matrix, this higher self that created you or that you're an aspect of or a spark of, this higher self, is it off doing other wonderful grand things? Is it living in life? Does it ride on motorcycles? Or does it float around in a glowy ball all the time? You ever think about that? I do. Now, the reason I'm talking about this is because I want to talk about the idea of a higher self and what Gandhi said. Gandhi said something? Yeah, Gandhi said this now. Well, I didn't come up with it. Gandhi said, be the change you want to see in the world. What if, it works like this too, be the change you want to see in your Overself, your higher self, your Oversoul. Do what? Yeah. We want... a lot of us want, to, in this ascension experience, we want to bring the consciousness, the greater consciousness that we are, into the embodiment of our physical life. That's kind of, yay, more me. So, what am I, mini-me? Well, that is major me and mini-me here. And the major me is the higher self. Is that how that works? What does the ego have to do with this? Rich, I know, ego. The ego self is not the true self. So the true self, the great consciousness or the essence that we are, that we become when we stop with the thinking and talking and creating ourselves or thinking about ourselves and what we like, what we want, what we desire and how we feel. It's a me, 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 me. So if I stop doing that and I quiet the mind, do I become more conscious? Yeah. Do I become less the thinking ego self? Yeah. So as the ego self, can I just like give myself up to my greater consciousness? As in, I am the ego self talking here now. By some teachings, that's how it works. I am the ego self. So for me to be the greater essence and the consciousness that I truly am, I need to shut the fuck up and just be here now. What fun is that? You know, there's no fun in that. There's some great delight in doing it. I'm not saying don't do it. I'm just saying, as we work out what an understanding of our higher self and the lower, that would mean that I'm the lower self, if that's the higher self. Major me, mini me. Me. Well, that would be ego, wouldn't it? So how about self? Let's talk about myself. Well, if I'm talking about myself, am I talking about my ego self? So am I mini, am I the mini ego and that's the major ego? What the fuck? What? Yeah, I know. I'm just laying it out on the table so we can kick it around. I do have a plan here. Okay. I mean, I'm trying to get somewhere with this conversation. So, the point I'm trying to make is, it would be great for a person to be clear on what they mean personally when they talk about higher self. Okay. Is that the same as Oversoul? Is that the same as Oversoul? Is Oversoul the same as Oversoul? You know, I'm not the guy to tell you which way you should label these things. There's a concept here, and we put these labels on it. So let's look at the concept again. The concept is there's this greater consciousness that I am and that you are. And apparently, a lot of us are feeling like that greater consciousness isn't here now. Okay? And it's not just more awareness. It's like there's this greater level of responsibility, this greater knowledge, this greater knowing, this feeling more alive, aware, awake, more powerful. Our intentions are stronger in our greater major self, higher self, Oversoul, or that true essence that we really are. So, how do we get that here? And the question has to be asked, is it always here? Is it here now? Well, if we are looking at the phenomena of being able to talk to our Oversoul, our higher self, as another spiritual being, it's another me or another you, and it's in the spirit lands, it's in the higher planes, it's not in the third density, so we have an out-of-body experience, or we have a dream experience, or we have this meditation thing. And we literally are talking to another being. Like, here they come. Ooh, look. Here they come. Look, there they are. Ah. Ooh, and they're all glowing and ethereal. And they're all, ooh. And they might be a round ball, or they might have a shape and form. And you look closer and you go, oh, my God, that's me. Yeah. And so that phenomena, let's talk about that. Okay. We're talking about that one. Okay. So it's another being. And they're running around, and they do things. They live in a sort of a time stream if they want. That self is the greater self that I am. So that's what we're talking about. Now, you can use any of these labels you want or come up with your own. But we're talking about a phenomenon now, not a label or a name, okay? There's this. You see this thing. People have done this, so I know it's an actual phenomenon. So I talked to my higher self, you know, right? I saw my higher self. I met my higher self. This happens. So we're talking about this phenomena. So this higher self, the idea is to bring that higher self or invite that higher self into the embodiment and merge with the consciousness that I am, the lower self, you might say. Okay, so there's this lower self, me, here I am, and there's a higher self. And the only difference we can assume or imagine or theorize, okay, the only difference is that if we here are calling that the higher self, we are considering or knowing or understanding that that other self has a greater level of consciousness and awareness. Hmm. and ability, and a life or an awareness of the greater reality, life beyond the physical world, the physical plane of existence. Okay. So if that's what we consider this other self to be, and we also consider that that other self has its own personal point of view. It can merge and be the point of view here with me, and it'd be my greater self being here with at one with this self that I am. Or it can not be here and it's off doing other things. And my personal point of view isn't always the point of view of the over-self, or the higher self. Okay? And this is because consciousness has the ability to create points from which to view. And we're fractal in a way, which means if I create two points of view, both points of view will have the same, there's nothing different about them. They're exactly the same. They're both as aware, both as conscious, as each other, because they're both the one, but becoming two. One, two. Same guy, same girl, spiritual beings, as it were, and put two different points from which to view the universe or the universes, the physical reality or anything. And as each one of these points of view from the spirit, from these two different points of view, have experiences, these experiences are different. So the ideas about life become different. And so these two become different in that way through experience. So ultimately, what happens is that these personalities are developed, characteristics, each from each perspective, there's the ability to create amazing universes from each perspective. So they do. Sometimes they create together. Sometimes they go off in their own directions and do things. So this whole concept of consciousness and what it can do, we're looking at this from the perspective of being here in the physical world, and we're asking our higher self to be at one with us. Okay. Well, let's think for a second that your higher self hasn't created just you. There's a lot of others that are like you that your higher self has created as well as you. Now, from this perspective, you don't remember. Too much time has gone by, too many experiences in the physical universe, too many lifetimes, too many going unconscious and waking up in a new body and not remembering Jack. Too much of that shit's going down for us to always be connected with the concept that as the higher self that we are, the Oversoul, the Overself, whatever you want to call it, this higher self has created more points of view than just me. This is one. So, when I am asking my higher self to be at one with me, I have to ask me, is my higher self really paying attention to this me? What if my higher self has created thousands or millions or billions of me's, mini-me, okay? And what if all the great consciousness and the higher self needs to do to create these is to imagine, hey, I know, I'm going to go that way. I'm going to go in that direction. There's a lot of stars and galaxies that way. I'm going to go that way for 1,000 years at light speed. But you know what? I'm going to stay here too. So just having the idea or thought to do that creates that secondary focus. The primary focus stays right here. That great consciousness, that the over-self that I am, is right here, fully aware and tracking with what I'm doing right now. But every time I think a thought about going in a different direction, doing a different thing, this can manifest as a secondary reality. And from the point of view of this other, you know, choosing to stay this way and choosing to go that way, well, this consciousness, from this point of view, this all is real. Everything is going on for the next gazillions of years into infinity and time exists for this self. It doesn't exist for this self. That's all potential. But for this self, this is potential. From this self, this is the greater real reality, right? And everything in this universe of experience from this point of view has to be created by this perspective. Okay. So in that way, the great God consciousness is creating all that is all the time, from this perspective and from this perspective. But they become different realities. They become different realms, planes of existence, different universes, alternate, parallel dimensions, universe. Okay? So, Seth, in the book Seth Speaks, talks about this subject. Not the details or not the way exactly that I'm talking about it, but he'll give you a basic rundown of what we're talking about here. Okay? So, if I want my over-self, a higher self, to be at one with me, I want if my over-self can be responsible enough for this creation of me, and that's what I'm like, hey, help me, please. You're so freaking powerful, you can just think things and it happens. Great over-self of all. So we're asking for this greater consciousness to come in, the embodiment, in here, right now. Well, what if all you have to do is be the change you want to see in the world of your over-self? Well, what do you mean, Rich? Well, act as if you are the over-self. You are the higher self. I act as if I am the higher self. And I become, imagine myself to be that great higher self that I'm wanting to bring into my consciousness. Why do I want them? I want to be more awake. I want to be more aware. I want to know more. I want my life to go better. I want to feel better in it. So, if I sit here and imagine a future life for myself, a way to live my life. I imagine this way. Oh, I become a movie producer. Oh, and in here, then I can imagine another life of being a psychologist. Ooh, and in this life, I'm a rocket scientist. And this one, I'm a brain surgeon. And this one, I'm an astronaut. And I'm a fireman here. I've always wanted to be a fireman. Yeah. Ooh, I want to be a river raft guide, because that's a really great adventure. I want to be an Imagineer at Disney World, create those wonderful rides and amusement park things. Yeah. So, have you ever thought about all these different things you could do in your life? What if every time you think one of those, you create those mini-me's? So now you are the over-self relative to the thoughts you've had about who or what you can be. And just think in the thought, manifests and creates those many different yous. And each one goes off in its own direction and becomes, and they're alive. It's fully conscious. They know everything you know right now, except they made that decision to be a this and to be a that and to be a one of those. And this is, but in this alternate reality, it's going to be one of these. And a cop here, and a fireman here, and an Imagineer here, and an astronaut there, and a psychiatrist there, and a psychologist there, and a scuba diver there, and you name it, you've thought it up, and it happens. But not in your primary focus, not in your primary reality. But there it is. What if it works that way? So this is just a theory. Just try it out for science. Take a look. That's heavy. Hey, that might work. I like that. I hate that. That sucks. So I just created that many different selves, thinking that many different things about my own shit that I'm saying here. Okay, but none of them are my primary focus except this one. For me, but each one of those others are their own primary focus, and I become the secondary focus. So I become unreal. Well, they, in each of their realities, are the real McCoy for each of them. And they see the entire universe. They see everything, all the people and everything. Each one individually sees that. And each, where you are right now sitting down and looking at your walls and your computer and the people in your life, you have to create that to see it, to feel it and experience it. In your great consciousness that you are, it's you that's creating it on some level of consciousness. Okay. So what I'm saying here is if you want to bring in your higher self, teach your higher self how it's done. You here can go, okay, I'm going to assume the position. I'm going to do over-self or higher self practice. I'm going to practice being the higher self, the kind I want to have for my, the kind of a higher self that I would like to have, come into my embodiment and make me more awake and alive and aware, and everything starts going right, and the things I want happen, and everything's all really neat. Because I got this greater consciousness that where it just, this is all great, right? So what I do here is I imagine a day in the life of myself. And it's not this primary focus life, because this is a primary focus. This is the reality of higher self. I am higher self now, and it doesn't matter what I'm doing in my own personal life. I am creating alternate lives. I'm creating more me's, mini-me's. I'm creating more points of view, levels of consciousness, aspects of self, every time I think about them. So I'm thinking about this one self. But now I'm going to take more responsibility than I've ever taken before on creating the life of this self. And we do it in our imagination. We just think shit up. Okay? So when we imagine or we spend a daydream about what we're going to do, that self lives on. Just try this theory on for size. Does it really, Rich? Yeah. Give it a shot. So you've got this self, and let's say the self is going to do a video today, this one. I'm going to get done with this video, and going to feel real good about it, and have a lot of energy, and see expansive horizons, feeling great consciousness and awareness, strength of character. A sense, this me that I'm creating, it's like being a computer programmer, writing a computer game, a role-playing game, and you're giving the primary character all its attributes. Oh, let's give it a high intelligence, let's give it great courage, let's give it charisma. And does it have any sword fighting skills? No. It can drive a car really fast. Ooh, that's good. Charming with the ladies. Oh, yeah, you got to have that. How about, so you design the qualities and the character in your imaginary self that you're imagining is going to have a wonderful life. So if you sit down right here as your regular human self and pretend that you can create the perfect you, if you just sit down, focus on it, think about it, and do it. So you can create these qualities in another you, not this you. You're not trying to make this you be that you. We have too many belief systems in place and limiting beliefs and issues going down that this me may not feel comfortable or believe in becoming this me. And so that would inhibit or limit our ability to create this imaginary self, this perfect self. Okay. So it's okay, you can be the biggest fuck up in the world or the greatest musician in the world. but you want to be a surfer for the rest of your life, great. Create this you that way, with all the personality and good looks and charisma and good fortune, too. You go to bed every night feeling good. You feel happy. You did what you chose to do. You can wake up in the morning, you're going to make a lot of money. You're going to meet new people, fun, friends, family. Oh, the next time you see that relative that you like, but you got a thing and you handle it in you're being the over-self. You're creating the entire life or the key points in that life. It's like keyframe points in that life for that self. And when you feel like you've got it, you don't have to take it all the way to the end of its life, but you like set it up really good and you give it the juice, everything that you would like your over self to give you, you become that responsible. And you create an under self. And it lives on, not as you, but as itself. For you, it's just an imaginary thing. Oh, an imaginary me is off here, another imaginary me is over here, another imaginary is. Yeah, that's right. That's what over self, your over self, and my over self could be doing. Oh, they're looking at me as an imaginary self. They gave me a certain level of consciousness and awareness and intelligence and stuff. And they just thought me into existence, right? Just, hey, I know, I'll be a human. Yeah, hey, I know, I'll think I'll create myself in a physical universe and I'll do that for a few billion years and then I'll pick up I don't care what the hell it does. You know, I created that consciousness. I'm out of here. I'm busy doing other neat shit, right? And so here's a little Ridge going, where's my over-self? If your over-self can maybe very well be as responsible about you as you are for your under-selves. I'm just saying. If you want to be that change of great consciousness, play it out. Practice being a responsible over-self, higher self, over-soul. Well, how do I do that? I just explained how to do it. You pretend it. You create it in consciousness. You imagine it. You care for your ideas of what I'm going to do with the rest of my life as real people, like you just created a real person or a character in a computer game or a child. You take responsibility. You can. You don't have to. You can take responsibility for that. And the great magic that you are, you can create that entire life for that self. That's what you do. You imagine up, you think up shit for your daydream self. Oh, I'm going to be a race car driver. Ooh, yeah, I'm going to Europe. You create that. That consciousness that you create, it's imaginary to you. That thing, what if it comes alive? Okay. And it goes, becomes a race car driver. That's its only passion. That's the only thing you put in that little head of it. Its little head. It just wakes up one day, hey, it thought it was you before. It felt like you, I'm just sitting here in front of my computer, talking on the computer, blah, 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 watching YouTube channel and shit. You know, but all of a sudden, you're all inspired. Hey, I'm going to be a race car driver. And you are just fired. That's your only passion now. Why? Oversell. Jack that into you. And it's you. And it's more life, more passion. And just with the thought from Oversell. So you put that thought into you create all these little selves, or big, you know, you can create them big too, but there they are. They're your children, your progeny, you are the creator or the genesis of all these realities, those potential realities, okay? And as you create everything around you, including the sun, moon, and stars, each one of these create everything around them. Everything, the sun, moon, the stars, and every other viewpoint, and every other bit of consciousness within their realm and universe of experience. So it goes deep, and it goes, you know, infinitely wild and crazy as far as consciousness goes and creation goes. So if you want to be, if you want your over-self or higher self to be at one with you, when you create one of these consciousnesses or one of these ideas, oh, you just kind of spend a great day for yourself tomorrow. As many details as you can. And it doesn't have to be believable from your point of view. You're the magic creator like a computer game creator. You create that wonderful you. And then you say, and I am at one with you. I am always here for you. And you say that from the perspective of you are a God creator. You can have that guy win 4 lotteries tomorrow with a thought. Because you're creating that life from a higher perspective. You're the computer programmer. I'm going to computer. My guy's going to win 4 $80 million lotteries tomorrow. You know, your buddies are going, no, that's not fair. That's not fun. Hey, it's my fucking game. Fuck you. You create your own goddamn computer game. I'm creating my little people winning. And there's not a monster down the hallway and to the left with a big sword and it's a killer beast monster. No, no, no. It's a treasure chest full of treasure. And there's a babe. She's just down the way and on around that corner. And you create that for your character. And then you say, and I am here to be at one with you now. And we are at one together. And whatever you want, I'm here to help you get. And I can create it for you. And you practice this way, being the higher self that you want to see, the change that you want to see in consciousness and over self, you become. You become the change you want to see in the world of over self. Okay? So, I'm just saying. It's something to think about. Is it a theory? Is it the way it is? It's just stuff to lay out there, practice with, because you are such a powerful creator of all things that if you can imagine it, you can have it. You can create it. In this primary consciousness, it's part of the practice. Okay? As you learn and practice, you get better at it. You understand. You learn more about it. And you become the teacher or the philosopher yourself. You access your own truth, and you know, Jazz, as Rich is saying, or somebody else is saying on the internet, you can just like say, nah, I got it, this, I know how to do this, I'm doing this my way now, and you're off and you're running. Okay, all right, thanks for listening, and create a great day for yourself. Okay, I will talk to you later. Bye-bye.